Hey everybody, this is Larry Crowder from Larry Crowder and Forest Glory out of Washington, D.C., and this is the story behind the music. My story starts off in church. I grew up in church at a little church out of Washington, D.C. called First National Deliverance Center, 5400 in D Street, with my pastor, Pastor M.H. Johnson. And then I just got involved, you know, and when I got into school, in middle school and high school, I was a part of the marching band, the concert band, and choir. And really there, I really learned my skills and kind of hear tones and how to hear harmonies and things like that. DJ, man, I met him through the Argo High School Choir, which was the high school choir I was in. He was an alumnus and he came from time to time to help out the choir, help Mr. Murphy as the assistant director. Through that, our relationship was established. He started a ministry, which was Christopher Randolph and Gifted, a founding member of that. And he wanted me to be the MD of that ministry. And so he believed in me, he worked with me. I owe a great gratitude to him, to being where I am right now. The role of church started since the day I was born. I was born into this. As I got older, I've learned that you can be in the church building or be a part of the church culture, but it doesn't mean that the church is in you. Through experiences that my family has been through, what I've seen around me, I've seen God very present in my life. I've talked to him, everything that I asked him, you know, he made himself known to me personally due to things that I experienced and my struggles and my shortcomings. He's always proven himself to me. That is the reason why I stand to declare his goodness. I told God, to whomever and however he wants to use me for his glory, I said I'll go. I met my wife through my actual church at First National through a group called Chosen Praise. It was a praise and worship team that was started to actually get more youth participation in the church. We actually got to know each other, spent a lot of time with each other. We got married back in 2014, and we found out in September of that same year that my wife was diagnosed with breast cancer.
So on that Monday, she had told me that to get my breast checked. And I made an appointment, and on Wednesday I had the ultrasound. Then the ultrasound tech was saying that the mass of my right breast was too dense, so he said that you need to get a biopsy.
It was crazy because, like, it was the first few months of our marriage. It took us both by storm. I remember my wife telling me, she said, as soon as the doctor told her, she said God spoke in the spirit and said, it's not unto death. I wrestled with it for a while. I had a moment in my work office or whatever, and I talked to God and I left it alone, but I was a little worried still. It wasn't until I went to bed, I would leave that same night, and through a dream, God spoke to me and told me that she was already healed. You just haven't seen a manifestation yet. That time was very, very stressful because it's our first year of marriage. I was putting out my first EP at the time with my group, just getting to know the married life, ups and downs and stuff like that. To see my wife go through that was one of the hardest things, to see her lose her hair. Many times I remember comforting her, crying and saying, you know, I wish this was over. But God has been faithful. He brought her out, months of chemo, months of radiation. God brought her out. We had a report that she was no longer cancer-free. To God be the glory. My wife was cancer-free, and then a year ago, we got diagnosed that my father had cancer. So it seemed like it's just been sickness around my family, and then my brother-in-law had some type of sickness going on that was showing me. Everywhere we looked, we had sickness or death in the family, so much going on. But my father is still yet cancer-free. To God be the glory. went through his chemo, went through his radiation, and God brought him out as well. I'm a witness, and my family is a true witness, that if you put your trust and your faith in God, He is faithful to His word. Sometimes we ask for faith, and my wife will always say, we ask for faith, but sometimes we don't know what test or what trial He may allow you to go through just to test that faith. He'll give it to you. You just don't know how He's going to give it to you. But one thing about God, He's faithful to His word, and He will always prove Himself. If you just lean and depend on Him, His word will not return back to Himself void. There's a scripture in Isaiah, I believe it's Isaiah 61, where it says that the Spirit of the Lord has come upon me to heal the brokenhearted and to comfort the needy and so on and so forth. That's really the heart of For His Glory of that ministry. You know, everything that we do, my passion, who we are, is just to do for His glory. I want Him to be recognized. I want Him to be the star. I want Him to use me however He see fit, that He may get the glory, because I realize without Him, I am nothing. One of my first songs that I wrote about a good 8 years ago is called Don't Take Your Spirit. It was inspired out of Psalm 51 when He said, "Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation and hold me by your free spirit. Lord, don't take your joy from me." That song basically came from my heart and where I was. I remember God spoke to me. He was like, "I haven't left you. I'm just giving you a taste of what it would be like if I did." I know now that no matter what you do, the love and the grace of God is there to catch you. And so because of God's grace and God's mercy, I am where I am today because of Him.
Welcome back to Babby's House. I am so happy to introduce you to Larry Crider and For His Glory.
So living by that Isaiah 61 scripture, God has blessed us. We've been together since 2013, and we have been to hospitals, we've been to nursing homes. We made that a part of our mission, and we've traveled around the DC area, DMV area, just to go to various concerts and musicals and stuff like that. And everywhere that we've went, God has put His approval. We've seen hearts change, we see people come to Christ. Around 2014, we started to get nominations. I was like, "Oh my goodness, we get nominations for awards? I would never imagine that." We received an award in 2016, which was the Blockbuster Showcase Music Awards for the Best Choir of the Year. And in 2017, we were nominated, I believe, for 3 or 4 Rhythm of Gospel nominations. We also were nominated for the People's Choice, and we actually won that award.
Talk to me about your heart for the gospel.
Oh, wow. I love Jesus. He's done so much in my life. He continues to show me His grace and His love, and I'm forever grateful for that. You know what I mean? And a lot of people, like you said, they're focused on the awards. They're focused on, you know, all the wonderful stuff. But He said, if you seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, all the other stuff will come. You don't have to seek those things. If you put Him first, and sometimes I know where I'm coming from, that can seem cliche. It's always put God first, put God first. But if you really put God first and really strive to have a life that's pleasing before Him and try to walk that straight and narrow path, God will. He's faithful to His word. You know what
yes,
I mean?
He is.
So I'm just grateful. I'm grateful for all that He has allowed me to.
Amen.
Right now it's 2019, preparing for our new single. Our new single is called The King Is In The Room. This basically just talks about the kingship, the authority, the rule, and the reign of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Talks about His sovereignty and talks about, you know, the lordship of who He is, and also encouraging us to let us know that no matter what our issues or what our problems are, He's in the room. All we have to do is reach out and trust in Him. He's right there when we need Him. So I just want to encourage everybody to make sure you go out and you get that single. The pre-order is June the 1st. The release date is July the 1st of the new single, The King Is In The Room. And you can find us on all social media outlets. You can also be reached at our website at officialforhisglory.com. That's www.officialforhisglory.com. You'll get all the information you need on us. You'll get videos, you'll get a biography. All information on For His Glory that you want to know is right there on that website. The King Is In The Room. It's going to be out everywhere July the 1st. July the 1st. Make sure you get it. Make sure you put it on your calendar. Make sure you go out and get it, y'all. 99 cents. The King Is In The Room. Thank you guys for your support and for your time. God bless you.